Hello and welcome to Harper Broadcast. I'm Amrita Tripathi in conversation today with Devapriya Roy, who is the author of the Vague Woman's Handbook, the Heat and Dust Project, and the Weight Loss Club. Devapriya, start by telling me a little bit about what you're working on next.
Oh, so the new book is, it started out as a graphic biography of Indira Gandhi. And then I thought that, you know, perhaps graphic biographies are something that parents want kids to read rather than kids, you know, actually reading it themselves. So we've got a graphic biography, which is framed in a little novella about these young, about this little young girl called Indira Thapa and her relationship with her very young teacher. Miss Rima Das. So, you know, it's like, so together they are also talking about Mrs. Gandhi. And so we've got Priya Kurian is the graphic artist. Mm. And it's totally experimental and we are right in the middle of it.
So you were telling us that Dom Moore is writing.
Yeah, so I've been reading lots of biographies on Mrs. Gandhi. And there are many, in fact, some say that Nehru is probably the most written about Indian politician, but there are lots of books on her as well. Dom Moraes, the poet, his is a very sort of whimsical, eccentric biography. It's, and so among all, you know, if you were looking for a really detailed biography, you'd look at Catherine Frank, which is the most recent, or Pupul Jaikar, who was sort of a friend of Mrs. Gandhi for a very long time. But Dom Moraes is the most odd. But because he's a poet, it's got a lot of interesting insights, you know?
Yeah.
That's why I'm... So this is what I'm reading at the moment.
Awesome. And you're quite a prolific writer. You enjoy writing. You have... Devapriya has a great column in Scroll as well, which I love reading. And we tweet about a lot. So we've come to you some of your recommendations and some tips, because you do interview writers as well, which I found the last... piece was quite fabulous. But tell us a little bit about what went into this one, because I know this was a really unique kind of experience, the Heat and Dust Project.
Yeah, and this was sort of the book that we really wanted to write, you know. And this is, as you can see, a book co-written with one spouse, which is the worst idea ever. We thought traveling around India on a very tight budget together would be bad enough, but then turned out writing it together was even more difficult. So...
She says that in the sequel pending as well, right?
Oh, yes. Much awaited. Yes. I think that's why we are sort of, you know. But it's... this is the book that, you know, really shaped us as writers, I would say. That, you know, we had begun writing our first books when we came up with the idea of this one. And the reason was that I think both of us were... You know, we were engaging with India, but we were doing it... in our own sort of urban, city born and bred sort of way. And we wanted to break out of that, you know, that set.
Yeah.
So it's sort of a place where we meet, because he writes hardcore nonfiction, whereas I had written novels before. So this is narrative nonfiction. We are in the middle.
Yeah.
And this really sort of remade us as writers.
That's lovely. So it's kind of discovering your own writing style and craft.
And material also, I think.
While discovering India. And the idea was a shoestring budget, right?
That
was
kind of 500 rupees a day. And, you know, and the other rule which sort of enforced was that, you know how Buddhist monks are cautioned against sleeping under the same tree for more than 3 nights in a row? Because the human mind is such that you get attached to even a tree. You know, so the tree is going to be like your home. It's going to be my tree. So, you know, so you had to keep moving. So that's what we tried to do. Keep moving from place to place without getting attached to anyone.
So on that note, let me ask you, what are you reading now? What's on your summer reading list? Because a lot of it is...
So because of the whole graphic biography thing, I got into a lot of graphic books, different kinds of genres within the graphic novel framework. So graphic memoirs was one. And this book is my current, like, comfort book, you know. It's called Relish, My Life in the Kitchen. And it's a graphic memoir about food and life and You know,
oh, nice.
Yeah, it's very charming.
Yeah.
So, so it's got recipes too.
Oh, cool. Okay.
Yeah, it's a really adorable sort of book.
Yeah.
You know, so when you're tired of all the intense literary stuff, this is a very nice book to dip into.
Okay.
So this would be one recommendation. The other would be, again, this is something that Priya Kurian, the artist I'm working with, she sort of told me that you must read this because, you know, this is called Wonderstruck. And this is a book that is told in both words and pictures. So it's got this stunning sort
wow.
of artwork,
yeah.
but it's also got prose. So there are two parallel narratives, one only told in pictures, one told only in
That's
words,
amazing.
And they meet at some point. So this was quite a revelation for me.